as a reference, but this is also very loose. You're going to start with the spoon when it actually stops being curvy, and from the part that is straightened down, you will take that length and put it down here, make another mark, and that's what you're going to cut. It is okay if it is not such a beautiful cut at the end, because it's going to be covered. Now, the part that you cut, this little trim here, is going to become her bottom. So if you want her with wide hips, you keep it this length. If you want her a little skinnier, you trim it a little more, which is taking about 1/3 of the length. And we're going to tape. We're going to make some markings in our spoon. The face is not going to be in the inside, but in the outside or backside of the spoon. And we're going to try to make her face more like a child than a grown-up. And to do that, we have to put all the face features lower in your oval over here. So in a regular adult face, the eyes would be around here. In a child's face, would be lower. This would be the central area for her nose and where to locate the mouth. And we're gonna have this line for the eyes, which is from the middle down, down the middle line, one notch down. And then the nose, and then the mouth. Her face would end somewhere around here. And this is just very flexible. You can pretty much put them wherever you like best. But let's start from some markings so we don't get too lost. The natural, realistic eyes, you fit one eye in between. This is a doll, so you pretty much can do whatever you want. But we're going to have them just a little more separate than what it would be for a more realistic face. Okay, since this is wood, it's going to grab the paper clay very well, very nicely. You don't need to add anything else. But if you want to, you can use some clear gesso or white gesso or even black gesso if you want to. I'm going to work straight from the wood up. And for those that are not familiar to paper clay, it is an air dry clay. It is wonderful, but it dries right away if you leave it in the open, because that's the whole point of it, that it dries with the air. So once you have your paper clay bag open, take a little pinch and put the rest in a Ziploc bag or any other reclosable bag, tight. Make sure that it doesn't have any air anywhere, and put it on the side. So now, to work on this, you wet the surface just a little bit. We have our water here. Not soaking wet, just a little damp. And we are going to, first than anything, add the eyes. I forgot to mention that some spoons are made out of bamboo. So you will need to sand first to make sure that it will grab, or give it a gesso, a prime first before anything else. And I was already forgetting that what we want to do for the face is lift it from the spoon. Excuse me for that, I totally forgot. So we are going to smear a little pancake of clay. You don't need your tools, but if you feel like using any tools, just don't make it too thin. And keep it as smooth as possible. This can take a good while, depending on how thick your first layer of clay is. And how large is your spoon. Don't get scared if you see a lot of little fuzzes running away from the center of your spoon. Just wet them again. Okay, so we have our spoon almost even. That should do, because we're still going to build from it. Okay, so we come and get our clay again. We are going to make very tiny little marbles. Make them as identical a size as you can. And remember, our aim is to have them from the middle of the spoon down. You calculate where exactly, or how apart you want the features, but this is more or less the example to follow. And you're going to have a little bit of a triangle. A little bit of a triangle. You're going to put it in between, but lower. I'm using an old brush to smear it down. I think it was a bit too wet. But that's okay. Okay, this is a profile. I don't know if you can see it. And now we're going to put another little triangle, but this is going to be, instead of with the pointy part up, is going to be with the flat part up. I don't know what happened to my little spoon that I had, but okay, we're going to lift this a little bit, trying to make the top of some lips, and then we're going to make this one curvy, kind of towards the bottom, and then we're going to trim it quite a bit. Okay. If your clay got too wet, just wait a little bit for it to dry and then you keep working. So at this point I'm going to wait a little bit because I think my part here from the lip down is a bit too wet, too soft. So I'm going to let it dry a little bit. Okay, from here, we're going to add a nose. I think I need to make the face a little smaller. I mean the lips. Put this shape like a little roll. Then the cheeks. The cheeks basically will have a little bit of a curve for the eye. It's not exactly a triangle, but it has a little bit of a curve for the eye. And if it is a little too long, you just take it off. I think I made this one a little too big, but it's okay. We just keep adding and taking and adding and taking. That's pretty much what sculpting is. Adding and taking clay. Now with your damp brush, you're going to soften. Try to get a soft brush. I think this one is a bit too hard. Now, we're going to make two little rolls. Very little. This is not letting me roll anything on it. Too slippery. Okay, this is still a bit too thick, but let's try it. This is one, you cut it in two. You're going to put it with a little bit of water. Smear the edges till you trim them. And try to leave the face, or the eyes actually, surrounded by the clay in a way that is the eyelids. And it doesn't look like popping out completely. Then from there, we're going to make a very thin part over here, very thin, like super thin, almost like paper, so it's not too bulky. And we're going to put it, trying to shape the around the eyes, see, it's going to be the forehead. Now the nose. Take a pinch, and whatever the pinch you got, get half of it off, because we always take way, way, way too much more than what we needed. Centered it. With your brush. Smear it to the sides. Very gently. Before my camera stopped, I had made the face just a little shorter. That wasn't filmed, but I just went with my thumb like this to shorten the face. And I just softened the cheeks a little bit more. The light is not helping me, but I hope you can see the details. Okay, whenever you have to stop working, just cover your face loosely with a little bit of plastic so it doesn't start drying unevenly, okay? So at this point, I will add a little bit more of clay around these areas where, as you can see, there's like a little sunken area. We want it all cheeky. And I'm going to add a little bit more over here, and then we're going to make sure that her eyes are happy. If you don't want happy eyes, you can just leave them with the lids kind of falling in an angle towards the edge, like this. That can change the expression. But we're going to aim for a smiling, or at least kind of happy expression, if the clay will let me, because I had to wait a little bit longer and it's kind of dry by now. Okay. We add a little bit of water, a tiny, tiny piece of clay. soften with our fingers. The most important part is that we don't let it all bumpy. We're still going to sand after we're done with the sculpting part. I'm discovering that it's kind of hard to keep an eye on the screen and the doll in my hands. I think I have the close-up a little bit too close. There's more evenness now. Now with either the pointy tool or some other plastic pointy thing, you're going to work to make the lips again visible. After adding that other clay, you can always soften again and again, okay? Don't worry if your line was kind of funky. You can smooth it again. And if we need, we add a little bit more clay. Oh, actually, the next part that we have to add is the little sides of the nose. Okay, we're going to add tiny, 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 tiny beads of clay. We're going to wet the sides, not too wet, but wet enough that will be like a glue. And then we put the little beads on each side. Flat like little pancakes. Smooth with your brush or your tool. Now we're going to have another extra little ball. Teensy bit more of water. Another little ball on the top. That would be the very tip of the nose. We soften. Make sure that it's attached in every side. You are like painting, but smearing down, smudging down, making sure that all the lines disappear. And see her profile, maybe this way. Okay. Now, with something pointy like a pencil or something, You're going to make the teensiest of holes in her nose. Make sure you have them even, or as even as you can. All right. If you see it upside down, you can check that it's centered. And we're going to now wet a little bit under her eyes and around. We're going to have some extra little rollies of clay to have like lids. You part it in half. You put your pointy end that you made towards the inside of the eye. Okay. I was out of the screen, but anyway, you make the little lines and soften again. This part towards the end of the eye, you flatten so much that it's gone. Can you see that it's totally gone? Now we're going to do the top just exactly the same. You wet your clay so it's nice and humid. This can be just a little thicker. Okay, you're going to have more than what you need, but just make sure that you're putting the tip all the way to the center, I mean the end of the eye, and then down to the other side. And gently take it all the way to the end. And make it disappear by pushing it into the other clay. While the camera was not running, I keep doing the same technique of smoothing with a tool or a brush, going up and down all over the areas that needed some extra smoothing, and I'm okay now with what the face looks like. It is a very simple way to make a doll. You can keep working on it and working on it, but I just want something whimsical and simple. And I think right now we are going to let her dry, and we will either air dry it by itself, or you can put it in the oven at a very low temperature for, I don't know, 20-30 minutes at the lowest warm temperature. That can sometimes make little hair, little cracks around. They can be fixed by, if you have a crack, you can just dig a little deeper in the crack, put a little water, and smear some more clay, tuck into it, the crack, and let it dry again. So what's coming next after being dried is that we're going to gently sand it with a very fine sandpaper. And then after that, we're going to paint.